students.
I am Poonam Ranjit Bhosle, assistant teacher of Nagar Parishad School number 3 Karad. Now today I am going to teach you the subject general science of standard 7. Now today's topic is the living world, adaptation and classification. In previous standard we have to learn also the living world lesson. In that we learn types of plant, classification of plant, types of animals and classification of animals. In this year we learn the adaptation and adaptation in plants in different regions. We know that different types of plants and animals living on the earth. In that some plants have colorful flowers, some plants grow in water. Here show in picture, that is lotus, whereas some are to be found in deserts which have scarcity of water. Scarcity of water means very less amount of water present in that region. Here is shown, that is cactus. Some plants are found only in snowy region, means that plant is not grow in other region. Some plants cannot be seen without microscope, whereas some are huge in size, means their size is, they are tall. In plants, like that plants, animals also show diversity, means some are unicellular. Unicellular means only one cell is present in that animal. For example, paramecium, amoeba, euglena, while some are multicellular. Multicellular, here sure, animals and even human beings are also. Some are vertebrates. Vertebrates means there is presence of backbone, and also invertebrates. All insects are including in invertebrates. This world is full of variety of animals, like aquatic, means that animals which live in water, they are aquatic. Animals that live on land, they are terrestrial. Animals that live on both water and land, they are amphibian. Animals that crawl, they are reptilian. And animals they fly, means that animal which fly, they are aerial. Now see, here is shown some pictures. Next, camel, brown bear, musk deer, snow leopard and wildcat. If you see that all animals live in different region. Now one question arises in front of us, that what is the reason for these differences? Next, now let's talk about adaptation. Gradual changes occur in the body parts, means that changes are done slowly, that changes done in body parts and also in the behavior of organism, which help them to adjust to their surrounding, to adjust in that condition, in that climate, in that surrounding. That changes done very slowly in their body parts and also in their behavior to survive in that condition. Here that picture, see that picture, ancient people, means ancient human being, how he see, and now present human, how he see. Now that human being, he is able to live in the present day, means he have adapted his body to live in present day. Now that human being is able to live in all condition, all climates, means snowy region, desert region, he is able to live. Now that changes are not done in one overnight, they take very long period, very long time to done. Next, now here is given one activity. Try this activity. Visit various water bodies such as river, brook, pond, lake in your surrounding. When you visit it, you have to observe plants and animals in that all places. What differences do you observe between terrestrial and aquatic plants? Now let's talk about adaptation in aquatic plants. Some of the aquatic plants are firmly rooted in the soil at the bottom of the water bodies. Their stems are submerged while leaves and flowers float on the surface. For example, lotus. If you observe the lotus plant, its root is firmly rooted in the soil and stem is submerged, means deep in the water, and we see only flower and leaves. Next adaptation, some plants are entirely afloat, means some plants are floating in for example, hydra, and their roots are not anchored in the soil. Here again, what adaptation is given? That surfaces of leaves and stems of many aquatic plants are covered with waxy layer. There is presence of waxy layer in leaves and stem. Why it is done? Because for the protection of water from water. Because of that waxy layer, that leaves and flowers are live as it is for a long period. Again, their shape is thin, slender like a ribbon. Because to withstand a fast current of water, their shape is like a ribbon. Again, one adaptation here is seen. That is presence of air spaces in petioles and stems. What is meant by petioles? There is a stalk of leaves. It is called as petioles. Because of that air spaces, that plant is going to be very, very light, and it is able to move in water firmly. So let's talk about adaptation in desert plants. Here is given again one activity. Here is shown two pictures. It is a cactus plant and it is leafy plant. Take two potted plants, one cactus and other leafy plant. Tie plastic bags loosely around the leaves of these plants and keep them in sunlight for early in the morning. Now in the afternoon, bring these pots into classroom or your home room and observe them. Has the same quantity of water is shown in the plastic bags of both? You will observe that. Now see, here is shown one picture. Which is that plant? Cactus. Now it is a desert plant. Desert plants are either leaf flakes or their leaves are like small needles and have been modified into thorns. Means there is absence of leaves in that plant, and that leaves are modified into pointed thorns. Because of that thorns, it prevents process of evaporation. Now what is mean by evaporation? Means conversion of water into vapor. This is the process of evaporation, and because of that thorns, it prevents process of evaporation and it consumes water. Now see the stem of that plant. It is fleshy, green in color. The stem stores water and food because of it is fleshy, and also it performs the very, very important function. It is photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Do you know about photosynthesis? Means it prepares their own food in stem in the absence of leaves. Now here again one adaptation is seen in desert plants, that their roots are penetrate deep into the soil and some roots spread away into the soil in search of water. We know that in Rajasthan there is absence of water or very less amount of water is present. To in search of that water, their roots are go away, and because of that they are firmly rooted in soil. There is a thick layer of waxy substance on the stem of these plants. In aquatic plants also we see that waxy layer, and here in desert plants also we see that waxy layer. Why that waxy layer here is seen? To prevent that process of evaporation. Because of that, waxy layer is present in desert plants also. Now let's talk about adaptation in snowy region plants. Adaptation in plants of snowy region. Can you tell in what way are sloping branches useful to plants in a snowy region? Now observe the picture. It is deodar tree. Pine tree and deodar tree is present in snowy region. Now see that shape of that plant. It is conical in shape. Because of that shape, it is called as conifers. Now see here, sloping branches are present here. Because of that sloping branches, that it prevent accumulation of snow on that plant, and that plant is also having thick bark. Because of that thick bark, that plant withstand in heavy snowfall and adverse condition. Now let's talk about adaptation in plants of forest regions. Here we see variety of plants like trees, shrubs and herbs. Winter trees, herbs, shrubs, also vines and climbers also seen in that forest. These plants compete among themselves for sunlight. For sunlight, if one plant is tall, other is short, then that short plant for getting sunlight, it also grows tall. And climbers and vines take support of that plant and they also grow tall for getting sunlight. Here, again one adaptation is seen, that small spring-like dendrils are seen on that vines. That dendrils take support of trees. And because of that dendrils, that climbers grows tall. Next. Now, let's talk about adaptation in grassland plants. Now, see here. In our eyesight, all grass is seen. There is not trees seen here. Here, in grassland, there is various types of grasses and bushes is seen. That grasses are having fibrous root. That fibrous root hold the soil firmly, and because of that, that grasses prevent soil erosion. Do you know about soil erosion? Soil erosion means wash away the upper layer of soil. How it is done? Because of heavy rainfall, flood or storm, that soil erosion is done and it prevents fibrous roots. And in that grasses, animals like tigers, elephant, deer is hidden. In cold region, small grasses is seen. In cold region, we see rabbit animal. Next. Now, in this session, we learn adaptation and also adaptation in aquatic, desert, grassland, snowy region plants and forest plants. Now, I hope that you understand all the part very properly. Now take homework. Question 1. What is mean by adaptation? Second question. Why camel is called sheep of the desert? Question 3. Why sloping branches present in snowy region plants? Question 4. Which factors shows adaptation in plants? Question 5. Which factors useful for growth?